Hello, this is the final video in SIREN's Sexual Health and Bloodborne Virus Program Planning Toolkit video series. This video and the corresponding toolkit section will support you to evaluate your program and answer the question, did your program work? This video will cover the value of evaluation, different types of evaluation and evaluation methods, how to work with both qualitative and quantitative data, how to analyse data, and how to effectively use and apply the results of your evaluation. Evaluation is the process of assessing the workings and effectiveness of a program. While evaluation is often undertaken for the purpose of reporting to funders, it has many more benefits than meeting funding requirements. Evaluation can be used to answer questions such as, has the intervention been implemented as planned? Is the program making a difference to the cause of the health or social issue that you're working to address? Is the program doing any harm? Did the program achieve its goals and objectives? What worked well and what might be done differently next time? And if the program or service should continue or if another approach should be trialled? Evaluation is often thought of after a program has begun. Ideally, evaluation should be considered early on to ensure that opportunities to collect valuable evaluation data aren't missed. For example, it's very useful to get a baseline measure of where your target group is at prior to commencing your program so that you can compare it to after your program has run. This can't be done if you've already commenced your program. Undertaking evaluation also provides you with data that you can promote and share with others working in similar areas so that they can learn from your work. There are three types of evaluation to be implemented at different stages of the program. Process evaluation measures the development and delivery of program strategies. Impact evaluation is undertaken after process evaluation has begun to assess the objectives of the program, which are the short-term effects such as changes to knowledge or behaviours. The program goal is measured using outcome evaluation and looks at the long-term effects of the program, such as changes to health or social problems. Process evaluation measures if strategies have been delivered as intended. It is used to measure the development, delivery, and progress of a program. Because it's looking at the delivery of a program, process evaluation should be undertaken throughout the life of the program, from commencement to completion. Depending on your program, process evaluation may ask questions about reaching the right people, if the program was acceptable and liked, if it was cost-effective and met budget, what strategies worked well, what may be done differently next time, and if participants were satisfied with how the program was run. Examples of process evaluation may include how many attendees were at a clinic, if participants felt that a workshop met their needs, or how many pamphlets were disseminated. Impact evaluation measures the immediate short-term effects of the program and tells us if the program is achieving its objectives. It measures the degree to which a program is having an effect on the target group's behaviours, knowledge, or environment. Impact evaluation can answer what proportion of the target group has heard of the program strategies. Has there been a change in behaviour, such as increased testing or vaccination rates? Has there been changes to knowledge? Do more people know where to find needle and syringe exchanges? Has there been a shift in attitudes? How exactly did the program change behaviour? What changed as a result of the program? And were there other changes that occurred that weren't considered before? Impact evaluation can begin after the program has begun to engage with the target group. You may wish to undertake it immediately after a workshop or a peer-based exchange, or wait until the program is completed. When to undertake impact evaluation will depend on your program. Whichever point in time you choose, you'll just need to make sure that you've allowed enough time for changes to occur. Outcome evaluation measures long-term changes and assesses if the program has met its ultimate goal, which is related to the health or social issue that the program seeks to address. Outcome evaluation may answer questions like, were there decreases in incidence or prevalence rates of the targeted health problem? Did the program lead to variations in mortality? Were there improvements to quality of life? What were the effects of policy implementation? And what sustainable behaviour changes occurred? As outcome evaluation is about long-term change, it usually occurs at the end of the program or sometime after. Again, the appropriate time will depend on the nature of your program and the program goal. When planning how you'll go about undertaking your process, impact and outcome evaluation, you'll need to consider a number of factors, such as how much time and money you have, if you have the skills required to design the evaluation and collect and analyse the findings, or if you'll need external support, if the evaluation is culturally acceptable. Keep in mind that talking about sexual health can be taboo in many cultures. You'll need to consider ethical issues. Can you ensure the confidentiality of the data that you collect? And what burden does the evaluation place on participants? As mentioned before, you'll also need to think about the best time to collect data. This will usually be the point in time where you're most likely to see the desired changes. When undertaking your evaluation, you can either use qualitative or quantitative data collection methods. Qualitative evaluation has a focus on words and meanings rather than on numbers. It provides an in-depth and rich understanding of participants' experiences of the program. Qualitative methods can be time-consuming and so are best for use with small numbers of participants. Examples of qualitative evaluation methods include in-depth interviews and focus groups. Quantitative evaluation methods, on the other hand, use numbers, frequencies, percentages, and statistics to measure change. Quantitative methods can be useful in large groups and is generally quick and easy to undertake. Quantitative methods are not as good as qualitative for exploring complex issues such as why and how a person's behaviour changed in response to a program. Examples of quantitative evaluation methods include structured surveys or clinical data such as the number of HIV tests. When undertaking evaluation, it's best to use a variety of strategies to increase the reliability of your data. There are lots of different evaluation methods you can choose from, including surveys, focus groups, observations, journals and art. And there are also many places that you can look for data, including statistics on testing, clinical records, websites and surveillance reports. Collecting and analysing your data, whether it's qualitative or quantitative, often requires specialist knowledge. Depending on your experience and your program, you may need to seek support at this point. Analysing quantitative data requires analysing and presenting numerical data such as attendance records, surveillance data or survey responses. Reliability and validity are essential for quantitative data analysis. This means that you'll need to show that your methods of collecting data were valid and effective. That means that they were designed in a way that measures what was intended. To ensure this, you may wish to choose quantitative data collection methods that have been trialled and tested previously. You'll need to ensure that the data collection methods are consistent and stable. This means that the responses would be the same regardless of who collected the data or when they collected it. And you'll also need to use methods that eliminate or reduce bias. Bias can occur when those who participate in the evaluation have different characteristics than those who do not participate in the evaluation, in which case you'd need to consider if your findings were representative of your target group or just a subset within your target group. Qualitative data analysis involves the interpretation and presentation of visual or textual data, such as interview or focus group transcripts, observational data, or artwork. A common qualitative data analysis technique is thematic analysis. This involves a process of reading and identifying key themes in written transcripts through a process called coding. Qualitative analysis can be quite a personal process that may be influenced by the experience, perspective, and knowledge of the person undertaking the analysis. Quantitative and qualitative research methods are not covered in detail in this video or the toolkit, but the toolkit does provide more information on where to look to find information on both methods. When you are undertaking evaluation, you'll want to ensure that the data you're collecting is practical and useful. It is no good to collect lots of wonderful data only to have it stored away on a computer or folder. Applying your evaluation findings to improve your program is essential, as is sharing the findings of your evaluation at conferences, on your website, through social media, or in reports or articles. When collecting evaluation data, there are two essential questions. The first is the so what, and this is about the importance of the findings. Is the evaluation data that you're collecting useful to informing program development, or is it just validating what we already know? If the data you're collecting is not useful, then consider what other kinds of data you could collect to inform program development and improvement. The second question is about the now what. This is where you need to consider what you will do with the information gained from the evaluation. Will the program be changed in any way? Will new strategies be introduced? Asking yourself these questions will ensure that your evaluation adds value to your program. Reflecting back on the program planning and evaluation cycle of planning, doing, checking, and adjusting, we see that evaluation is part of an ongoing process of the program lifecycle. It prompts us to check how the program is going and adjust or refine the program if needed to ensure progress towards the program goal. Changing from an outputs mindset to an outcome focus represents a fundamental shift in the nature of thinking and doing evaluation. It's a shift away from outputs or processes such as the number of participants in a workshop to a focus on the actual outcomes, such as changes to health behaviours. Outcomes are the tangible changes and the benefits of a program. Taking an outcomes approach requires focus from the very beginning of a program, where you set a clear direction for the outcomes that are to be achieved, and then work towards developing evaluation measures to see if you got there. That brings us to the end of this video series. We hope you've learnt how to develop high-quality evidence-based programs or services that will really make a difference to the health and well-being of your target group. There are lots of tools and resources within the Siren Toolkit and on the Siren website, so please check these out to continue your learning and application of program planning and evaluation methods. Don't forget, Siren provides strategic planning, evaluation, and research support. So if you need help with applying this toolkit or any other planning, evaluation, or research support, please get in touch.